on everything from Trump's White House to his campaign for re-election. Get it all by downloading America's Voice News app on your favorite devices. Go to americasvoice.news and make sure you download the America's Voice app on your Roku, Apple TV, or Amazon Fire device. You can also watch America's Voice on the Dish Network, Channel 219, americasvoice.news.
I enjoy listening to On the Mic with Mike every day at 1 p.m.
RVA's leading social enterprise show. On the Mic with Mike on WJFN Radio. Daily at 1 p.m. Mike King Biz, delivering food for thought. To find out more about the dynamic host of On the Mic with Mike, please visit his website at MikeKingBiz.com.
On the Mic with Mike, weekdays 1 p.m., part of the Midday Buffet on the all-new WJFN 92.7 and 100.5 FM.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to On the Mic with Mike RVA. It is the premier daily social enterprise business show here in the Richmond area. I'm your host, Mike King, and I appreciate you being here with me. There are a lot of other things you could be doing, but I appreciate you spending the time with us today. It is Friday. So the views expressed here are mine alone, have no connection to, support of, or an agreement with any other host, information, or ads on the station. Join me as this cutting-edge show uplifts the community and showcases RVA business in a different way. The sounds you're listening to are emanating from the Mike King Biz Studio, the global epicenter of social enterprise business. Joining us today, as always, is my man, the super producer, Al Green, who's on the wheels of steel, and we can be reached by calling 804-778-8888. So On the Mic with Mike highlights partnerships, people, social enterprise businesses, organizations, and we also deal with issues of the day. To get more information about me, please go to my website, which is MikeKingBiz.com. So we'd like to thank our show sponsor, Jimmy Comer, Chris Smith, the Community First. Those guys are always doing some great work in the community, providing financial services to small businesses, nonprofits, and also really making a difference in supporting organizations that are out there making a difference in the lives, trying to make people's lives better. So if you ever have any needs, make sure you check out Jimmy Comer, Chris Smith of RBI Services. Also, along the way, folks, we got to pay some bills around here. So, you know, we do have to go away and promote our advertisers and our advertising partners. So, you know, make sure you take a listen when the commercials are on. You have some awesome services and products, and they help us stay on the air. And we'd like to thank them for that. And they're also doing some great things in the community. So today, folks, the program On the Mic with Mike, the Game Changers come here to talk about what's going on. It is the place where people come to. Today we have with us, well, it's Friday, so you know what that means. It's Modern Love with Paula Pardell. She's in the house. She's going to talk about some RESPECT in relationships. So we're going to try and help you go off into the weekend with the love in your heart and try and find some help for you. We're also going to have Danielle Gilbert, serial entrepreneur, successful woman about town, a friend of my brand, and she's going to talk about some of the endeavors that she has going on. It's Danielle Gilbert, folks. Also, who's going to be in studio with us is Kim Ely. So, folks, she's a wordsmith. She's an author. She helps people. She helps you write books and express yourself. She is a master with the English language, and she's also a ton of fun. She's going to be here. But first, folks, to get the show started, we are going to welcome in Danielle Gilbert. Danielle, welcome to the program.
Yes, thank you for having me, Mike.
All right, so Danielle, I mean, besides, you have a number of things going on. You're a business and a kidpreneur's mom. You're a serial entrepreneur. Talk a little bit about what you have going on and how it impacts what has happened since COVID, and talk about your business model a little bit.
Yes, yes. So, hello, RVA, Danielle Gilbert, serial entrepreneur, international speaker, author, and a business owner of Manifesting You Consulting, a small business HR firm here in the Richmond area, helping small to medium business owners with their HR department. And so during this time of COVID, I have had to shift my business from a in-person HR professional to becoming virtual and finding different ways to be able to offer the same high-level quality services to my clients virtually just because of the whole pandemic. And so that has really had to allow me to show up differently, right, and be prepared virtually and use technology that I never thought to use before, such as Microsoft Teams, Zoom, and being able to connect and do investigation and things virtually. So that's one part of the mini hat, as you said, Mike, that I wear.
Yes.
I'm also an author of the book called The Unspoken Words, Pain, Patience, and Progress, that helps individuals through life's obstacles. I wrote that book 2 years ago when I left corporate America and really wanted to take what I have been going through from a mental illness perspective, depression, so really took all of my feelings and emotions and really put it all in a book. And that book can be found on Amazon. Again, it's The Unspoken Words, Pain, Patience, and Progress. What else do I do, Mike?
So you're a travel agent too, aren't you?
I am. So I am a travel agent as well, called Galen by Gilbert Travel. So part of that brand and my motto is that I am an event planner. And so I have Galen by Gilbert Event Planning. And what I did when I started my event planning company back in 2015, I wanted to be able to have a one-stop shop for my brides and the groom. And so I decided to become a travel agent to be able to give them not just their wedding of their dreams or their birthday party, but I also wanted to be able to help them travel and find the honeymoon, or if they wanted to go just on a vacation, I wanted to be able to allow them to come back and just utilize me as their travel expert. So I have coupled my event planning company along with the travel agency together.
All righty. So talk to folks a little bit about so folks, the voice you're listening to is Danielle Gilbert. She is what are you? You're a serial entrepreneur. Serial entrepreneur, a woman about town. You're a mom. So talk a little bit about the M&M creator side.
Yes. So aside from all of the hats that I wear personally and for my professional, is that I also have groomed my twin girls, Mackenzie and Mariah, into being entrepreneurs. So the name of their business, you can find them on Instagram and Facebook, is called M&M Creative Art. And these two beautiful young girls have decided that they wanted to take their creative side and actually they create scented bracelets and necklaces. They've also recently introduced slime. So they have 17 different types of slime that they've actually created themselves. They do T-shirts. They do artwork. And then in the next 30 to 45 days, they have a new product that's going to hit the market that I'm super, super excited about, that they're going to create. And we're going to hit the social media with that. I'm not going to go too much in detail.
That's right. You can't give it away. You know, you got to. The twins have to come on the mic with Mike when they, you know, when that drops, because they're TV stars, they're radio stars. We've done a ton of things. Tim, talk a little bit about the importance of multiple streams of income.
Yes. So, you know, one thing, Mike, that you and I've always talked about it, and what's dear to my heart is, what I've learned is working, it's nothing wrong with working for any company, corporations, but being in corporate America for 18 years, I learned that I had a different passion, and I wanted to be able to build my own wealth and become my own CEO. And throughout that process of being in corporate America, I loved what I did. I loved helping others, but I wasn't walking in my purpose or my passion. So part of creating multiple streams of income is really walking in your purpose and passion and building your own stream of income and having multiple levels of that, right? And that doesn't necessarily mean to do what I did and go out and have multiple businesses, but you can literally take one business and create multiple levels of income within that one business even from HR. I have multiple ways that I make money out of my HR company. So it's not just consulting, but I teach HR certification classes. I have electronic ebooks for people who just want to go through a ebook at home on how to figure out their career values. So it's really just figuring out what you want to do and really building your own legacy and understanding your why. So my why is very simple. I have a family. I have two beautiful girls that are looking at me every single day, and they are looking at me on, Mommy, how are you going to make sure that we have what we need? And so I have developed in my mind, and I execute it every single day with my affirmations and my gratitude statements, that my why is these girls, and I'm going to continue to leave a legacy for them when I'm not here.
You are doing a great job. So one last time, let folks know how they can find and keep up with Danielle Gilbert.
Yes, so you can find me personally on Facebook and Instagram at Danielle M. Gilbert. The name of my company is Manifesting You, and that's Instagram, Facebook, and then Mackenzie and Mariah is M&M Creative Arts, all on Facebook and Instagram.
All righty, and so when the big information drops, make sure you bring the ladies, come on, and let us know what's happening so we can help push it for you.
We will do that, Mike, and I appreciate you as always.
All right, appreciate it. Thanks. Now, folks, Danielle Gilbert, we'd like to thank her for joining the program. With that being said, folks, the time is 1:18. It's On the Mic with Mike. It is the business show that people come to talk. We talk about everything under the sun. So today we have with us, up next, we're going to have Nicole Reed from Nicole Reed Real Estate. We have Kim's in the house. We have Paula Pardell talking about love, where it's an action-packed show. We'll talk to you on the other side. Thanks now.
Before and after, the salon has been active in the Richmond, Virginia community, providing hairstyling services for over 10 years. Before and After is located in downtown Richmond at 1917 West Carey Street, specializing in weaves, extensions, and growing healthy hair. Before and After provides a full suite of hair care services. Expert stylists Michelle Smith and Alicia Clark are well trained to meet your styling needs at Before and After, the salon.
Welcome to your neighborhood wellness store. Your journey with wellness is our number one priority. We can help you navigate your journey through our cold-pressed juice bar, CBD products, health and wellness products to include hemp shea butter. Relax and unwind in our Wi-Fi lounge and more. We are located at 14822 Hull Street Road or online at yes2hl.com. Phone number 804-818-2867.
Hi, my name is Daquan Whitberry, also known as Chef PQ. The restaurant industry is going through a hard time right now. With COVID-19, a lot of things are going on, restaurants are shutting down, they might have to even close their doors for good. In the past few months, we've seen how life can change dramatically in a blink of an eye. Fortunately, I've created a system, a proven system, that allows restaurants to stay successful in this new way of life. As the owner of RVA Cafe, I would love to help you through these challenging times. Go to redindigofood.com for more information.
Hi everyone, it's Pavi Leitner, the CEO and founder of FinLit and your family's certified financial educator, dedicated to the financial success of you and your family. Are you not sure where to start with your finances? Or are you looking to sign your middle schooler up for our virtual camp? Book us at www.finlitva.com. That is www.finlitva.com. FinLit is creating a money conscious community.
Did you know embroidery is an easy, low-cost way to market your business? Let Godmama Wear LLC assist you with your custom logo embroidery needs. Whether you need shirts, hats, or yoga mats, Godmama Wear can embroider various items. Visit us online at www.godmamawear.com. That's www.godmamawear.com. Let's talk soon.
Chris Shipp here with Focus Floors, and for the month of May, we are offering a free upgrade in any Bona water-based poly for any job, that gets put on our schedule. You can reach us at focushardwoodflooring.com or just check us out on Facebook or Instagram. Facebook, Focus Floors 804, Instagram 804s. Thank you.
Hi, I'm Reba Hollingsworth with CBS 6, and I was on the mic with Mike and had a fabulous time. Make sure you tune in every week.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to On the Mic with Mike. It is the premier social business enterprise show in the Richmond area. Folks, we're moving today. I mean, we are not playing around. We'd just like to thank Danielle Gilbert for coming in. Up next on the microphone, we have Real Estate Royalty and my partner from way back. Nicole Reed is here giving us what's going on in real estate. Plus, she is the queen of branding. You know, she taught me what I know in this business about branding. And she's a true master at it, besides selling a ton of real estate. Nicole, welcome to the program.
Thanks, Mike. Thanks for having me again.
Okay, so you tell us about real estate, and then do you have news to drop on us, too?
Yeah.
Okay, well, come on. We got to start talking.
Oh, okay. Can you hear me?
Pull it closer.
Pull it closer. Okay, I got to pull this.
Oh, there you go.
There we go. Boom.
We want people to be able to hear Nicole, so... Microphone check, 1, 2, 1, 2. There we go.
Awesome. So, I mean, the real estate market is just super crazy. It's on fire right now. So, everything is good. I actually just got a new listing
that hit the market today. So, if anybody's looking to purchase a home out in Henrico County, 4-bedroom, 2.5-bath, listed at $295. It just freshly hit the market. Waterview 2, Lake in the back.
Is that your, what is the keys to close?
Giving you the keys. I don't know. You always talking about a slogan. I don't know. I think Mike made this up. I don't know.
That's true. Okay.
So but my thing is, my three letter that. Words is clear to close. That's what I love to hear.
Clear
I think that's
close.
Where you kind of get
that's what I'm, okay. So it's clear to close. When that's Nicole. But you're real estate redefined now.
We are real estate doing real estate redefined.
Okay. So absolutely. Talk to us about what, so how's the market? Why do you think the market is the way it is, and how long is it going to?
Well, I mean, that's the big question. How long is it going to last like this? Like I said, the market is on fire. We've got houses flying off the market in hours, days, literally 10, 15 offers for one house. One of the reasons why we have that is because there is a shortage. And if you've done any research or reading, we're probably at the highest percentage of shortage that we've ever seen in real estate. So you're talking about... Generally, our shortage is maybe about 10%, but we're looking at about 30% shortage.
Wow.
It is crazy, but this will explain the reason why you have so many people going after the same houses and why houses are selling at $15,000, $20,000 over what the actual list price is. So, and it's just a shortage of inventory. So if you have been considering selling a house, how about now is the time? It is a seller's market. Definitely reach out to me, Nicole Reed, with Nicole Reed Real Estate, 804-721-7630. You know how I like to always.
Yes, you know, she's going to make sure she gets the plug in there. That way you know where to find her. Nicole Reed Real Estate. Also, okay, so give a person a tip to make sure that their house is ready to go and to be able to get the most out of it.
You know what? Number one thing is curb appeal.
You say that every time.
I say it every time because that's the first thing somebody sees when they drive by your house. That's going to determine whether or not they're actually going to walk in the house. I've gone to houses with a client and they see the outside and they say, never mind.
Okay.
So it does happen. So curb appeal, you definitely want to have curb appeal. And you want to make sure that your house is actually prepared for the market. 80% of people or buyers actually search the internet first and view pictures first before they even consider stepping foot in your home. And if those pictures don't look good and you have not presented your house in its best effort, they're not coming to look at it.
Okay. Let's talk about, so last time we talked, how's the credit market for people with the, I guess, the approval process? How are people doing out there these days? Has it changed?
A lot of the guidelines haven't changed yet. We're still in this COVID thing. So, you know, the guidelines are a little bit stricter. Again, as I mentioned last time, I still do work with lenders that are doing 580 or below 620 credit scores, but you know, you're going to have to provide additional documentation for those type of financing as well. But they're still being done. I just did one, so it's happening.
All righty, so folks, the voice you're listening to is Real Estate Royalty, Nicole Reed, who's in the house. When we were here, you were here before, you told us that a certain number of agents sell a certain number of homes in the market.
Yes.
Could you give, okay, the reason we say that, folks, is everyone under the sun is a real estate agent.
Everybody.
Everybody's a real estate agent.
I'm not knocking the hustle at all.
We don't knock hustles around here. That's what we do. We give everyone a shot. But tell folks the number of people who are selling the home so that people can get an idea. This is time to, you know, to toot your horn a little bit.
Yeah, I mean, the percentage is very low when you look at how many people are licensed here, especially in the Central Virginia region. We're talking about 5,000 agents out here that are actually licensed, and probably about 3% of those are actually actively selling homes and selling more than 12 homes a year. So
12 homes a year,
yes. So I mean, there are people who have their license and they're selling a home a month, you know, that equals up to 12 homes a year, but there are, most of them are not doing more than that.
Most of the agents are not selling more than 12 homes per
right.
year.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, and so how do you get the word out there to let folks know? I mean, you have your social media game is on point. What's the difference between Nicole Reed and the other folks?
I mean, it's definitely about visibility and getting out there in the market and marketing yourself. But I always say that people will do business with people that they like, know, and trust. So, you know, being able to be the resource and being able to provide that information that they need. A lot of people have dealt with me on a professional level before I was even into real estate. And so they know my work ethic. They know that I do what I say that I'm going to do. I'm very responsive. And all of that takes effect in how productive that you're going to be in this real estate market. You can't be so busy that you can't provide the customer service
that
that's needed.
True. So folks, the voice listening to is Nicole Reed. Nicole Reed is going to come and drop in and give us the real estate update on a regular basis. But I think she has some news that she wants to talk about, you know, about her next step in the things that she's doing to get her brand out.
Oh,
there.
Yeah. Well, you know, I was on the mic with Mike. with 92.7 FM.
Yeah, in another life, didn't you?
In another life. Yeah. But I am moving over to 96.9 FM come August 8th.
And that is the Real Playbook.
That is the Real Playbook radio show with your girl, Nicole Reed, in Nicole Reed Real Estate. And we're talking about all things real estate.
See, folks, that's what the On the Mic with Mike program do. We, you know, she taught me branding, and we kind of fell into this real, you know, this radio thing together. Now, so good luck to Nicole. She's going to make sure she'll find time to come and work with us, you know, and let us know. But make sure you check out the Real Playbook. So, Nicole. Little bit. One last time, let folks know how they can find you.
And you can find me on all social media sites. That's Nicole Reed Real Estate 1. Reach me at 804-721-7630. Website is NicoleReedRealEstate.com. If you're looking to buy, sell, or invest in real estate, contact your girl.
Hey, folks, Nicole Reed, the best in the business, my friend. And also, she's a killer when it comes to business. So that's for sure. Don't let the look fool you. So thanks to Nicole. She'll be giving us updates as we go around. Thanks, folks. We'll see you on the other side with Kimmy Lee. Thanks, Dan.
With SRN News, I'm John Scott. On Capitol Hill, Dr. Anthony Fauci has told lawmakers that once a coronavirus vaccine is approved as safe and effective, Americans should have widespread access within a reasonable time. Officials say a military seafaring assault vehicle with 15 Marines and a Navy sailor aboard sank off the coast of Southern California, leaving one of the Marines dead and eight missing. Forecasters have declared a hurricane watch for parts of Florida. The coastline as Hurricane Isaias drenches the Bahamas on a track for the U.S. East Coast. Officials in Florida say they're closing beaches, marinas, and parks in Miami-Dade County beginning tonight. Isaias with maximum sustained winds of 80 miles per hour. On Wall Street, stocks now mixed. The Dow down 211 points, but the NASDAQ ahead 34 points. This is SRN News.
Drowning in IRS debt? If you can't afford to pay your IRS debt due to economic hardship, you can now be free of IRS collection efforts by taking advantage of a special IRS tax hardship program. This program allows Americans who owe the IRS to resolve their delinquent tax debt once and for all. In some cases, maybe even reducing what you owe significantly. An open phone line has been established by Community Tax for consumers to call and see if they qualify. Simply dial 800-308-7862. If you owe back taxes to the IRS and cannot afford to pay them back or have years of unfiled tax returns, help is standing by. Just call the Community Tax Helpline today at 800-308-7862 for the help that you need. Don't take on the IRS alone. They can attack your wages, savings, pension, home, and even your Social Security check. Call 800-308-7862 to see if you qualify. That's 800-308-7862.
Did you buy?
As a doctor and a business owner with 15 employees, I know how hard this shutdown has been on our families and our society. I took an oath to do no harm and promote safe and healthy living. That could mean encouraging patients to take better care of themselves or taking common sense precautions to protect themselves from a virus. I'm confident that the time has come to start reopening our communities. Because we know who is at low risk, we can let these individuals get back to work. We also know which groups are at highest risk and can focus our resources on protecting them. By working together, we have flattened the curve. Now it's time for Main Street to reopen.
By working together, we were able to flatten the curve, but now it's time to flatten the fear. By taking common sense precautions like social distancing, the vast majority of people under the age of 65 are at very low risk. Together we can open America. Find out more at flattenthefear.com. Brought to you by the Job Creators Network Foundation.
Welcome to the SBA Weekly Business Tip. I am Martin Shulk, the U.S. Small Business Administration, Virginia District Office. Under COVID-19, this is definitely the time to review and possibly revamp your business plan. A business plan is a roadmap to guide you in the launching and operating of your endeavor. The plan provides an outline for the framework of your business. It declares your business's vision and next steps. It also models your core values, mission, and addresses your direction. Visit us at sba.gov and click on our Learning Center tab to learn more. We're here to help you start, grow, expand, or recover.
Does your home need a makeover? If so, refresh with quality with LA Labor and Painting, LLC. They make your home sparkle and be the envy of the community. They are masters at interior and exterior painting, drywall. They clean decks. They landscape and remove items you wish were gone. The bottom line is, they refresh with quality, provide professional service, and follow all guidelines regarding COVID-19. Call today to make your home sparkle. You can reach LA Labor by calling 804-972-8014. Call today for the On the Mic with Mike discount. When you mention the program, you'll receive 20% off of the beautification of your most prized possession. Call LA Labor and Painting today at 804-972-8014.
Thank you, attorneys Justin Lauder and Chris Gatewood at Threshold Counsel PC for sponsoring this program. They offer startup, business, and intellectual property services for innovative and growing organizations. You can find them online at threshold.cc.
Hello, everybody. I'm Jimmy Stump with Stump's Pig and Pint. We're located on the corner of 2nd Street and 119 East Lee. We specialize in slow-cooked meats, handmade sides, and homemade desserts. Stop by. Let us take great care of you. You can find us on Facebook at Stump's Pig and Pint, or you can give us a call, 804-477-3208, 804-477-3208. We look forward to taking care of you soon.
My name is Isabella, and you're listening to My King Biz Hubby. That's my skin.
Mm-hmm.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to On the Mic with Mike. Yeah, that's my granddaughter, Isabella. That is the promo. So the program is On the Mic with Mike. We're here daily with you from 1 to 2. We'd like to thank the folks we're in. But right now, we got to keep things moving. We have Kim Ealy in the house. And so for folks who know, she is a bundle of energy. She's a wordsmith. She's an author. She's a ghostwriter. And she's kind of like a Renaissance woman. We're going to talk about some of those things. Okay. Let folks know who you are and what you do.
Absolutely. First, I am so thankful to be here. Well, thank you, Mike.
Well, we're glad to have you. We haven't seen each other since our Synapse days.
That's right.
And so Paula just joined Synapse. Shout out to Synapse. Okay.
Yes.
So tell folks who you are and what you do, girl.
Absolutely. Kim Wells Ealy, Kiwi Publishing, KWE Publishing. And I take people from idea to published book. I'm a writing coach and a publisher, and I love what I do.
You do love what you do.
I do.
And so, you know, some of the things, let me go through some. I know you from a number of different things. You were the scribes at some point.
Yes, the sociable scribes. Yes, sir.
So talk a little bit about the meaning of words and how they help business and how life has changed since COVID has happened for you as a business.
Oh, absolutely. So words are so powerful. We talk a lot about branding, like you were talking earlier with Nicole about that. And the way that we represent ourselves through our words is part of our branding and what we represent. I love helping people to craft their message so that they can bring attention to their business. I call their book a business card on steroids. And things, you were talking about how things have changed because of COVID. I have really had business boom. I've been so tickled because I wasn't sure how this would impact everyone as far as being able to have the money to invest in writing a book. And actually, in April alone, I booked 4 new clients, which is huge.
Congratulations on that. So let folks know the process. Now, I have an idea rumbling around in the head. How do you take that, and what's the process to go from idea to published book?
Absolutely. So I sit down and have a one-on-one conversation. We get super crystal clear. We create what I call a strategic plan that identifies the author's intention, message, and ideal reader. That helps us with not only marketing, but also the focus of the book. We start from there. We write up each chapter at a time. That's where I have my writing coach hat on. And then we get to the point where we edit, format, create the copy of the book cover, and then we publish. And when they publish, they get published on Amazon, Barnes & Noble, and lots of different online retailers.
So, folks, the voice you're listening to is Kim Wells Ealy. Kim Wells Ealy.
Yes.
She is KWE Publishing. She has a lot going on right there. She helps a lot of people with the writing process and giving folks the meaning of words and the value of them. You do a lot in the community, a lot of community endeavors. You do.
Yes.
So talk a little bit about, I don't know if it's woman empowerment or it seems to be that.
Absolutely.
The platform is yours to talk about that.
Well, thank you so much. Absolutely. I so believe as women that we need to lift each other up. I believe all people should lift each other up, but especially other women. I love empowering them. I belong to a group called Fab Women.
And with Shauna?
Yes. Oh, she's a powerhouse.
Yes, she is. You know, shout out to her. And so it's a collaboration of women who support each other in all of the endeavors that you guys do.
Absolutely.
There's no competition. It's just about women helping each other.
No, absolutely. And one good example of that is you had mentioned about sociable scribes. My awesome, I call her my partner in fun, Nikita Rowell Stevens.
You guys are a ton. Shout out to Nikita. Okay, we have my man Al Green over here because we're trying to hold it together. Folks, the time is 1:39. Kim Wells Ealy is with us right here, KWE Publishing. And we're talking about, so you guys were the sociable scribes, is that?
Exactly, we still are. We still have our podcast. We're doing season 2 right now.
Okay, so you got to give a shout out for the podcast. You can't come here and not shout out your podcast.
Absolutely. Sociable Scribes. We're all over the place. iTunes, Stitcher, Spotify. But what we do, we're 2 writing coaches. And the funny thing is, you would think we would be competitors, right? We support each other. We lift each other up. She and I talk. We love to talk about all the questions that we get from awesome authors or author-to-be, including how do I get started? Where do I begin? And we talk all about writing, publishing, the good, the bad, and the ugly. And we have a fun segment called Gregarious Goofballs.
There was a video that you guys were outside doing something, and it was hilarious. You guys are great together.
Thank you.
So we've talked about that. Now, you know, this is a serious business program here, and, you know, we take things serious.
Yes, sir.
I had seen you and your skydiving efforts.
Yes, sir. Oh, okay. My goodness.
So talk a little bit about how you get to the point where you're working with the business coach. You guys are sort of working with each other. You end up jumping out of an airplane.
Heck yes. So Brian Mooka, also a member of Synapse, wrote a book. He's the Fear Sherpa, and he wrote a book called Your Secret Superpower, Taming Fear to Thrive, all about how you can use fear to be an ally instead of an enemy. And when we were talking about his book launch, I'm like, holy cow, what better place than to do a skydiving book launch? He actually used to jump out of planes in the Navy in the dark. I don't know how you do that.
You know, it's funny because I used to do that in the Army.
Did you?
That was a young Mike.
Woohoo! I'm impressed.
Thank you. This is the radio Mike. So you talked to Brian about that, and you thought that'd be a great idea.
Absolutely, and it was. We had his book launch in an airport hangar. And so the adrenaline was there. It was the perfect atmosphere and energy for his book about taming fear. And then we all got in the airplane. Well, not all of us. A few of us got in the airplane and jumped out. And it was amazing.
Yes. Yeah, so I saw the video.
Yes.
And you truly enjoyed yourself.
Thoroughly enjoyed myself. Thoroughly.
For people who've never done it, explain to them the feeling. People always say, why would you jump out of a perfectly good airplane?
Yes.
And it's a feeling like no other. Tell folks a little bit about that and how it correlates to being a business owner during these crazy times.
Oh, that is a perfect question. It is a leap, right? We take a leap of faith as entrepreneurs and people in business. When you are first up in the airplane, you get excited. The hardest part is looking out that open door, and you're like, holy shnikes,
yes, for sure.
What have I done? And then all of a sudden you get out, and once you leap out, you feel so free and weightless. It's incredible. And the same thing is true in business and in going out and doing activities in these COVID times. It can be scary, but once you take that step, a controlled step, you don't go out without your parachute.
No, that is true.
But once you take that controlled step, it is so worth it. Everything that you want is on the other side of fear.
Oh, I hear you. So, folks, that's Kim Wells Ealy. She is talking about fear and overcoming it, writing books. So give folks an idea of the steps to take to go from idea in head to being published.
Absolutely. So the first part is, I always recommend contacting a writing coach.
And that writing coach would be?
That would be Kim Wells Ealy. And then having a serious chat. And even if you're not quite ready yet, it's always smart because writing a book is an investment of time and money. So the sooner you can start thinking about it and planning for it, the better. Have a serious conversation about what's your intention? You know, what is your message that you want to get out there for the world, especially for entrepreneurs like your listeners? It's such a smart way to get your word out there and also establish your credibility as an expert. There's nothing better. So once you get crystal clear on that message, contact me.
All right. And how would folks contact you once again?
Absolutely. My website is kwepub.com, or you can contact me at 804-536-1972.
All right. We'd like to thank you. You got to come back again. You got to come back because I always say words have a real meaning, and, you know, what you're doing out there, plus what you're doing with the community. Shout out to Nikita and Shayna, and tell them I said hello. And thanks. So, folks, we'd like to thank Kim for coming in, and we'll talk to you on the other side. We'll be back in just a moment with Paula Pardell with Modern Love.
Thank you.
Appreciate it. Thank you.
Oh, that was fantastic.
So we're going to have you when
Hi, my name is Kashfia Rashid, but you can call me Cash. I am an accounting strategist. I help business owners set up and maintain a customized automated bookkeeping system. You see, accounting is the language of business, but not all small business owners are fluent. I translate accounting into English, empowering my clients to work in their zones of genius with comprehensive reports that easily show them the opportunities they can take advantage of to grow their business. I use automation to take care of the daily transaction processing, freeing up time, energy, and resources, all while restoring peace and sanity. All companies need a little cash. You can find out more on my website, www.cashthebookkeeper.com.
Hi, hi, I'm Roby Martin with CBS 6 Eat It Virginia, and I was just on the mic with Mike, which is AM 820 and FM 92.7. Me, Mike, Marcy, talking about all things Richmond. Tune in, man, tune in!
Ladies and gentlemen, it is Friday. You know what that means? It is Modern Love with Paula Pardell. She's in the house, taking us into the weekend and giving and helping folks find love out there. Paula, how are you today?
I'm awesome. How are you doing?
You are awesome. Okay, it's yours. So now the weekend is on. It's almost here. Let folks know what's happening in the world of love.
You know, there's a lot of things happening in the world of love. There's a lot of positivity and things happening right now. I think people are realizing that good relationships are worth it and that they really need to find good, healthy relationships. My phone has been lighting up lately. I've got a lot of people interested in what I do. They're looking for an alternative to the apps because they've been going on the apps and it's crazy on there.
All righty. So now today we're here to talk about, so they're the pillars, correct?
Yes, the pillars
We have covered which one so far?
We have covered boundaries and communication. There's five of them. There are more, but we'll do basically five. Boundaries, communication, respect, trust, and support. We've covered boundaries. We've covered communication. Today, I'd like to cover respect. Now, they all sort of circle around together, and they all intermingle together. You can't have one without the other. But it's important to talk about each of one of them individually. So I like to talk about respect, R-E-S-P-E-C-T, there's nothing else like it. You got to have respect. You got to have respect for others. You have to have respect for the people that you love, and you have to have self-respect too, or other people are not going to respect you. And respect comes in a lot of different forms. There's a lot of small things in a relationship.
Okay.
You know, we may not always agree with our partner, but we do have to respect them. We have to trust them and put faith in their judgments and their opinions. Trust and respect are something that's built up over time.
Alrighty, so folks, we're talking about respect today. Respect in a relationship, Paul is here talking about. It's a really one of the foundations of having a, you know, a good relationship, of finding someone. So when the folks are swiping left or right or whatever they're doing, you're helping with your folks find the meaningful relationships because you're working with them one-on-one.
Yes, it's a very personalized concierge experience. I take you through the whole process. I'm right there with you along the way. I'm coaching you, talking to you about the dates, and talking to you really before you do meet someone about, you know, what things you should expect and the things that, you know, are important in having a good, healthy relationship. You know, I don't want to just put you in any sort of relationship. I want to make sure that you get into a healthy relationship. And respect it's a big thing in a relationship. I think we've all been disrespected at times. You know, it depends on, you know, a lot of times on what we portray and a lot of times about the kind of people that we surround ourselves with. And a lot of it is also, you know, we don't always agree with the person we're in a relationship, in any sort of relationship. Fighting fair is very important.
Let's talk a little bit about fighting fair. What exactly does that mean? When people, are there boundaries, or is that what that means?
Yeah, boundaries comes into it, of course.
Oh, we're back to boundaries again.
You know, it all comes full circle. We can't have one without the others. We need to fight fair. We've all been in an argument with someone, and you bring up things from the past. You cut them down personally. You go way off topic about what the argument is about. We need to respect and value each other's feelings and opinions. We need to be able to express our own opinions without fear of retribution. And, you know, that by not controlling someone, a lot of people try to control you. And, you know, you can't allow someone to just try to control you.
That is true. So, folks, the voice you're listening to this segment is called Modern Love with Paula Pardell. She's a love expert. She's here with us every Friday talking about how you can make the most out of your love relationship. So don't swipe left or right or whatever you do. Contact Paula so that she can walk you through the process of how to find somebody, and we're not going down the same rabbit hole of looking at pictures and finding the one that I've been attracted to for the last 18 times that it didn't work out. So Paula, talk folks through your process, because that's what we talk about. It's not just so much, it's a process. You are talking about respect, respecting yourself. Don't get fooled by the shiny object that's out there. So you vet people. You want to make sure the people are who they say they are, so that when your folks meet up, there's a good chance that the relationship is going to be solid, because you guys are offering, you have something in common, because you've made a point of figuring out the things that are important to them.
Yes, we do. We base everything on compatibility. It's very important for me to get to know every one of my clients. I want to know what makes them tick, what they're looking for, what their goals are. A lot of people have a different idea of what a successful relationship looks like, and we want to put you in a relationship that meets your standards and your ideals. And we want to put you with someone that's on the same level as you. You know, when we do that by, I do that by asking a lot of questions about compatibility, your morality, how you've grown up, your past relationships. Are you looking to move forward and not looking towards the past?
Let me ask you with that one right there. You're asking a lot of questions. How do you ask those questions? Are they conversations, or do you fill out a questionnaire? Like, how does that work?
It's a mixture. I have a questionnaire, of course, with scientifically based questions that we ask you. And it's conversation too. I take a lot of notes, and, you know, different things come out at different parts of the conversation. And like you were saying, it's a process, and we go through that process together, and we learn a lot more about, you know, you may learn a lot more about you, and you learn about the process and about other people and how other people tick too.
So folks, the time is 1:53. Paula Pardell here. So there is a scientific approach to love and matchmaking, and people tend to shoot from the hip.
Oh, they do. You know, I like to say that I try not to let you get in front of yourself. You know, when you meet someone on these apps, and it's all based on whether or not you're attracted to them on a picture, we all put these rose-colored glasses on. I don't care who you are. I don't care if you're a doctor, a lawyer, or you're running your own multimillion-dollar company. We all do it. We put these rose-colored glasses on. We're not seeing the people how we need to see them. We're all goofy and got the butterflies going on, so we're not thinking about these important things of a relationship. So I flip that over, and I start you on a firm foundation where you're compatible with that person before you even meet them, and we've got the important boxes checked off. No one's ever 100% compatible. You don't want to date yourself, but we work on, you know, everyone has deal breakers, so we definitely abide by those, but, you know, like the rose-colored glasses thing, I think that's just, it's crazy. We all do it. We all think we're intelligent people, but we do that. We put our rose-colored glasses on, and we're not thinking clearly.
All righty. So, folks, Paula Pardell, the love expert, is in the house with us every Friday. So now, love matchmaking for a 30-year-old, how different is that for matchmaking for a 50-year-old?
Oh, my gosh, it's a lot different. The younger people, I think they still want to be involved online, and they want to be on apps. But I do offer a service for them where we help you with your online profile. We can write your profile for you.
Oh, wait a second. So you're helping people look better than they really are?
No. Oh, they really are. But
it's just helping dress it up a little bit.
Yeah. Dress you up a little bit. It is about marketing. You have to market yourself. You're putting yourself out there to a degree. You do have to market yourself. And the picture that you put out there, there are different beliefs that the different types of pictures that you put out there are going to attract a different sort of person. I know there's a lot of obvious ones that we can think of that we see online, but there's a lot of subtle things also, and a lot of it's about how we write our profile. I have someone that's awesome. She'll take over your profile for you. She'll write it. We'll attract the kind of person that you want, and she'll take the messages for you too, and get rid of the trash and send you the ones that she thinks have potential. It's not as vetted as what I do, but it is a service that we offer for younger people that still do want to be online. But then when we get to the older people, a lot of them have been online and they're just sick of it. And a lot of younger people too, you know, you're just sick of the online. You want to get off it, completely off it, and have someone help you find someone, you know, that's not crazy. That, you know, we do background checks. We vet everyone. I don't take everyone on as a client. You have to be positive and you have to be open-minded.
All righty. So it's Bloom Matchmaking. Let folks know, because folks right now want to know, Bloom Matchmaking, where do we find you guys at?
I have a website. It's bloommatchmaking.com. Of course, I'm on Facebook. I'm on Instagram. I'm on LinkedIn.
You are everywhere.
I'm all over the place. And I'm on the mic with Mike also.
Well, that's true. And, we're glad to have you here because you bring an energy to the matchmaking part. I'm the partnership guru, but you are a true matchmaker. And that's something from a business standpoint, when a person says, what do you do? And you tell them, what's the next thing that comes out of their mouth? Like, you are what?
Yeah. They're like, wow, you're really a matchmaker. I'm like, yes, I'm a modern matchmaker. It's not that old fashioned, fiddler on the roof thing kind of matchmaker. I'm a matchmaker. Matchmaking is actually something that's exploding all over the world because a lot of people are looking for an alternative to the craziness online, and people don't meet each other like they used to, even pre-COVID. You know, you go out to dinner, and I hear from a lot of my clients that, you know, people just don't come up to you and buy you a drink. Everybody's got their face in their phone, or they're not interested in talking to anyone outside their circle. So it's tough. It really is tough. And now with COVID, it's made it even harder. But there's a lot of silver linings to COVID. People, I think, are really taking their time to get to know people on a deeper level before they get into these physical relationships that they really shouldn't be in the first place.
Ladies and gentlemen, that sage advice is coming to you from Paula Pardell. Really quickly, so this is a business show. Talk a little bit about the business of matchmaking. From an advertising, what can you do, what you can't do? Because people would kind of wonder, how do you get the word out that you're a matchmaker?
My marketing game is strong. I have
yes,
a very
is.
Good marketing company. We're all over Facebook with ads on Facebook. I'm on the mic,
on the
with,
mic
Mike.
With Mike.
I advertise at golf courses. I figured it was a good idea to advertise at golf courses because I think it's probably the only sport that guys can play right now. Our marketing game's strong. I've got a lot of different, my website, we've got different landing pages. There's all kinds of SEO tricks you can do and things like that. I've got my tech people that take care of that for me because I am a matchmaker. I'm not the tech person, but I've got very good people that do all those things for me.
All righty, folks, Paula Pardell, she's here every Friday talking about modern love. So quickly, let folks know once again how they can find you. And if you want to call in and talk to Paula, folks, make sure that you can reach her at any time. You know, during the week, you can call in here as well. Paula, really quickly, how can people find you once again?
My website is bloommatchmaking.com. I also have a phone. My number is 804-205-5063. I'm on Facebook, Instagram. Reach out and let me show you how you can find a healthy relationship.
Folks, that's coming from the love expert. I'd like to thank Paula for coming in as usual. So the program is On the Mic with Mike. It's Friday. We made it through the week. Paula is sending us off into the weekend with some tips on healthy relationships. I'd like to thank the guests this week who come through the program and made it the place to stop at in the Richmond area. On the Mic with Mike. We're here with you every Friday, Monday through Friday, 1 p.m. to 2 p.m. on WJFN. That's 100.5, 92.7, 820 a.m. I'm your host, Mike King. If you'd like more information about me and what I do, you can reach me at MikeKingBiz.com. If you'd like to advertise, make sure you reach out. So, Mike King, I'd just like to thank my wife. Baby, I'm on the way. Witness is over. Thanks to everyone who's listened, and we'll talk to you next week. Take care now. Thanks.
You're listening to WJFN Goochland, WJFN Chester.
Breaking news this hour.